Hello beauties, welcome back to my channel. So today I have a very simple video for you all, and it's just a haul video. And the reason I'm just doing a haul video instead of a makeup tutorial is because I had a full makeup and hair tutorial filmed, or I thought I had it filmed, and I went to transfer all the files over and start editing, and I realised that something had gone wrong, and I don't know whether my memory card ran out of space or something, but the makeup tutorial got cut off right in the middle. So that's obviously no good. So I had to just delete all that, and I still wanted to make a video because I know I haven't uploaded in like a week. I like how I talk as if I have about 1,000 followers, and I think I have 18 subscribers right now, but you know, still, like, personally I just wanted to get a video up, so I thought this would be a really easy video to do. And I have got some really nice products recently, so this is just going to be a beauty kind of just generally stuff that I bought recently haul. I'm not going to do a clothing haul because a lot of the clothing that I want to show is in the wash, so yeah. But I am wearing a really cute outfit today, so I'll show you that, because I'm wearing this shirt from Primark. It's just a sleeveless shirt. You may be able to see the bralette I'm wearing underneath, which is again by Primark, and then one of my favourite pink suede skirts from Boohoo. Just really pretty bracelet from Swarovski. Yeah, I just wanted to show that because I thought that that looked really, really, really pretty. I have to move again. So I thought I would start off with the only non-makeup product I got. And if you watch my Taylor Swift perfumes review, you will know that there was a Taylor Swift perfume called Made of Starlight that I did not own because I didn't know it existed. And when I went home, I went up to my room one night, and what was sat on the floor, because my mum had got it for me. Thank you so much, Mum. It was so kind of her. Like, I didn't even ask her to get it. She just got it for me because she heard me talking about it. But this is the perfume, and it comes, by the way, in a musical box, which when you open it, plays Starlight from the Red album by Taylor Swift. But this was actually released in 2014. It has a similar bottle design to the Taylor perfume and a really cool sparkling ornate design on the top. The smell is really, really beautiful. I forgot to write down the notes, so I'm just going to get up the page on my phone. So the top notes are mandarin leaf, passion fruit, and apricot. So this is a very fruity perfume. It's not really that floral at all. The middle notes are osmanthus, which is a plant, honeysuckle, and orange blossom. Fruity, couple plants in there, but it's not too sweet. It's a really interesting, like, unique fragrance. I really love it. And the base notes are musk, peach, and woodsy notes. So by the way, if you're wondering where I got all the information on the notes from my perfume video, it was this website called Fragrantica. You can see that. That is the website where I got all of the information, just, you know, in case you guys wanted to know. But this is absolutely beautiful. I love it. It's fruity. It's perfect for a summer day. It's a really nice all-round ear perfume. So, yeah. That, in terms of mood, playful. I would just say playful for this. It's playful, it's light, it's fun, it's made of starlight, like the name suggests, and this is just a really, really gorgeous scent. Whew. To start off with makeup, I got a new foundation, which I'm actually wearing on my face right now, so if you want to examine my face. I'm wearing the Maybelline Fit Me Matte and Poreless foundation in the shade 115. I got this yesterday, and I tried it out yesterday. I'm wearing it again today, and I really, really like this. I like that it has, I wouldn't say it's completely matte finish. I would say it's more of a natural finish, but it's really nice. It's very smooth. It covers really well. It's not full high coverage, but it definitely does give like covers up redness and that kind of thing, and like a couple blemishes that I have, it covers them up really nicely. Really like light, soft on your face. It doesn't feel like you have a lot of makeup on. It's nice to touch, it's long-lasting. I really, really, really like this. So, I've never tried any Maybelline face products before, like foundations or anything, and I'm very impressed with this one. So, Maybelline Fit Me Foundation, very lovely, 100% recommend. I also got a face powder, and I got a pressed powder, which I have not used in a very long time. If you watch my makeup tutorials, you'll know that I usually use, or always use, my Rimmel London Stay Matte, no, Match Perfection Translucent Loose Powder. But I ran out of that, so I picked up a Rimmel London again. This is the Stay Matte Long Lasting Pressed Powder. It's very lovely. And in a transparent colour, because I have a few different foundation shades and it's just easier to get a transparent powder rather than to try and find a powder that matches all the different shades, blah blah blah, you know what I'm saying. I like that it has like a little design. Is that gonna pick up on camera? I'm not sure, but it has like a little, there you go, a little crown kind of thing in it, which I think is really cool. And it's very smooth, it's nice, it's very light. I would recommend taking this powder with you for touch-ups throughout the day, because it doesn't like last all day by itself. It does say it gives like about 5 hours of natural shine control, so I'd say it probably does that. I just have a little bit of oilier skin, so I need to powder like every so often just to make sure that I stay nice and not glowy like a light bulb in a bad way. But I really like this powder. I think it's very, again, light, natural, breathable, not going to clog up your skin too much, so I really, really enjoy that. So this is the Stay Matte powder. I recently got a new blusher, and you guys know I love blusher, and I love this one. This is from Bourjois, and Bourjois is, I'd say, a little bit more of, it's a little bit more expensive in terms of like going by high street prices. But they're such good quality and they smell beautiful, they're very refined, so I don't mind every so often spending like a little bit of extra money if it's just like to get a nicer product, which these always are, and the packaging is always really sweet. So this is what it is. It's a little round pot blusher in Golden Rose. Can you see that? Is it focusing? Is it focusing? No, it's not, is it? Focus, thank you. Yeah, Golden Rose, and it comes with a little brush in it, which I thought was really cute. So you can see, this is the little brush, which actually is a very nice design because it's like rounded and it fits perfectly onto like the apples of your cheeks, and it kind of hugs it as it goes back, so cute brush. This is the color, it is so pretty. This is a baked blusher and it's the most refined, smooth, glowing, like illuminating product. I'll swatch a bit of it for you there. You can see it's so smooth and soft, and it's kind of like, it's a nice, it's not an in-your-face colour. It is pigmented, but it's not like bam, if that makes sense. So it's kind of like a slightly subtler golden rose blush, and it's so pretty, smells beautiful. I cannot say enough about this. It's beautiful and it's perfect for travel because it's so small and it comes with its own brush. So if you're going on holiday, I would recommend picking up one of these. So I'm going to start with the one that I'm wearing on my lips right now, which is beautiful, and it's another Maybelline product, and it is a Color Drama Intense Lip Paint. I think these are called Color Jolt in America, and I saw them because I was watching Jackie Y's makeup tutorials, and she used this, and she used this in a couple of her Instagram posts as well, and I thought, oh, that's really pretty, and then they came out in the UK, and I swatched them at a Boots, and I was like, oh, this is so gorgeous. So it's in a really cool, like feathery, soft applicator and you just squeeze it to get a little bit of paint out and apply on your lips. It is smooth, rich colour, which is really comfortable to wear. It gives like a matte finish. It's stunning. It smells really nice and I love it. I love this light pink colour as well, since as you can tell, I dyed my hair darker. It was dark like this in my last video and it's so pretty. I love, 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 love having my hair this colour. I just feel like myself, if I'm like, it's wonderful. I just love this colour. And I think it suits my face a lot more. And I love this lighter colour, especially when I have slightly smokier eyes, which we will get back to. But this is just so beautiful and it lasts quite a long time as well, and it's really easy to touch up. Like, I touch this up without a mirror all the time because you just go boop 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 and you're done. So I love this. The next thing I got is super cool and it's by L'Oreal Paris, and it's the Color Riche La Palette Extravaganza for lips, and the packaging is stunning. And you get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 lipsticks in it with a lip brush, which is so handy, and it comes with a mirror so you can touch up like all of your makeup in this mirror because it's a really decent size. And these are the colors. They are so pretty. The top might look like a yellow, but it's actually a gold. So you get a gold, a nice sort of poppy orange color, a matte pink, a red, and then two purple and a purpley brown color at the bottom. They're so stunning. The lipsticks, like, oh, L'Oreal lipsticks always smell incredible. They smell so good. They're very smooth. They're long lasting, and the lip brush is really, really lovely. It makes it perfect because they're all quite bold colors to get like the perfect outline of your lips. This is so great. I just throw this in my bag and then every so often I can just get it out. Check my makeup, touch up my lips, done. And it's so easy, so convenient, so I love this. I think it's perfect. And they do a few different color options as well, if I remember correctly. So you can get the perfect lip palette for you. And I thought that was really cool. I've never owned a lip palette like this before, so it's really, really nice. The final product I have to talk about, which I left for last for a reason, is an eyeshadow palette. And I don't know whether I put this on my Instagram stories the other day, but this is a palette that I owned before that I threw away because I didn't like it. I bought it online because this palette wasn't available in the UK stores when I wanted it, because America seems to get everything first. And like, we bought it online, which I'm now wondering, is that the reason that it was so bad? Because the pigmentation was so sheer, it was so annoying having to build up like 45 layers of eyeshadow on your eyes to see any colour, and I did not like it. They were not that easy to blend, they didn't blend together very easily, and it was just frustrating. They also faded very quickly. But I went into Boots and I saw that there was a tester of this, and I swatched the eyeshadows and I was amazed. It was like night and day to like the previous quality of the palette I had. I was like, I wonder if this has been reformulated, like this is so much better. And this gorgeous smoky eye, which I'm thinking I'm gonna do a tutorial on, by the way, if you like it, is actually using all colors from this palette, which is Maybelline's The Blushed Nude Palette. Remember when I used to use this like in my tutorials a lot? So pretty. I wish this had a mirror. That's like one of my only pet peeves about it. But the rose gold packaging is really pretty. I love this The Blushed Nude, like the way that it's written. Really pretty. And it says in the back 13 looks in one palette, because they organize it sort of in little duos, trios, and quartets. I haven't tested it. That would work. The quads would definitely work. I don't know whether the duos and trios would work because most of the light shades are on top. But yeah, it's really pretty. I just have to adjust my seat for a second. So I will swatch all of these on the back of my hand so you can see. So I'm probably gonna do a jump cut. So these are the shades. They're so pretty and they're so smooth and they blend really easily. They're very smooth, they're pigmented, easy to apply, they glide on really beautifully, last like really long time. What happened? I don't know, because I'm glitching. Okay, I'm sorry. The eyeshadows like in the pan don't necessarily look that good quality. I don't know whether that's just a me thing, because this, the layout of the palette looks a bit different than the one I had and the way it's advertised. Like the eyeshadow pan itself is a bit smaller and it's kind of set in a little bit. The eyeshadow is set in a tiny bit. But I really, really, really like it. Like, I think this is amazing and I'm gonna use it all the time. And it comes with a little brush, which I took out because I knew it was gonna fall out and annoy me. It's a little sponge and a little tiny brush there, which, you know, you can use. Like the sponge could be good for getting into your inner corner and your brow bone a bit. And it's a very small brush. You could use it for your outer corner maybe. I like this. I like the rose gold packaging. All of the colours, and except this, whoa, this one right here, are shimmery or metallic finish in some way. So if you don't like shimmery shadows, don't get this because you'll hate it. But, oh, it's so pretty. I can't get over how pretty this is. And look at the look I created. Like, I love this. It's romantic, it's kind of sexy, and it's pretty, and I love it. Like, so pretty. So I am amazed, I am impressed. I love it, it's romantic, it's beautiful, it's blushed, it's all colors that I love, and I'm really, really happy with it. So, Maybelline's The Blush Nudes Palette, you did good. So that is it for my little, like, haul video today. I really hope that you enjoyed it. I know it's quite simple, but sometimes it can be nice to watch stuff like this and, you know, see different products. So I really hope that you enjoyed this video and that you maybe got some new things that you want to go try out. I will be filming a makeup tutorial on this look very, very soon because I think it's absolutely beautiful. And that is it. I love you all. Check out my links below. I will list everything. I will link everything in the description. I love you all and I will see you all in my next video. Hope you have a lovely, lovely day.